I know you're very busy and we thank you for your time, pero tayo po, we thought that we'd talk to you again because the last time we spoke, eh, pinag-uusapan po natin kung paano matutulungan si Lydia De Vega. And today, we heard the shocking news of her passing. When did you hear about it and how do you feel?
Well, I heard about it like everyone else through the media early this morning. How do I feel? Siempre I feel sad. Lydia was struggling hard. You know, she had stage 4 breast cancer, but the problem was she had blood in the brain, and so that really affected her. Anyway, I'd just like to extend my condolences to the family. You know, Peter, Lydia was an icon of Philippine sports. And what I'd like to say is that sana her demise, her passing away, can help focus people's attention on Philippine sport and also her legacy. She has a great legacy. She is perhaps the most bemedaled Filipina athlete in modern Philippine sport. I don't think there's anyone else that's won as many medals as her. I'm not sure. Maybe there are other female athletes in other sports, but in track and field, she's the most bemedaled track and field athlete.
And we were trying to enumerate one by one all the golds and other medals and the certificates, Athlete of the Year awards. Ang dami, sobrang dami, Mayor. So you're correct, you know? And yes, she's probably the most bemedaled. But I'd like to refresh your memory. Palagay ko nakatulong nga po yung nabanggit ninyo, no, nakakausapin ninyo ang Pangulo to help, no? And I think, you know, a lot of assistance poured in for Lydia. Unfortunately nga po, hindi na po talaga nagtagal ang kanyang buhay, ano. Pero what else can be done to honor Lydia, Mayor Mike?
Well, obviously, I'll be getting in touch with Stephanie with her daughter later, and obviously maraming tao will go to the wake. And I will also take the opportunity to reach out to my relatives because I've been told that they spent a great deal of money at Makati Med. And they have huge bills. And that's the government can within themselves to really reach out and take Makati. So, as I said, she should be treated as such. She should be treated with great honor and dignity. And I'm sure that my relatives, I'm sure that the president, because the president Bongbong Marcos already came out with his own condolences on Facebook, and I'm sure that the family will reach out and do what needs to be done. And to do this because of Lydia's legacy. She is such a great legacy that, you know, she's brought so much honor and glory to the Philippine Republic that it is incumbent upon the Philippine Republic to pay back, back for what she's done. She's raised the Philippine flag maraming beses in international competition. And so I believe that actually things will work out and that the administration will reach out and take care of the family.
Mayor Kian, the last time we spoke, you mentioned that you were going to be contacting Lydia's family. Were you able to at least speak with Lydia for the last time before her passing?
To Lydia? Or, yes, to the, to or to the no, no one was
not
able
to
talk to Lydia. Lydia was incommunicado. She was unconscious. She's been unconscious matagal. She was not responding to people at all. But her heart was medyo malakas, and that's why people that the doctors kept on hoping that there was a possibility that she might recover. But lately, in the last, I think, 48, 72 hours, she really succumbed very rapidly. So, and this is the outcome now.
Uh-oh. Okay. Yeah.
But she wasn't placed in life support, Mayor, from what her daughter said.
Honestly, I'm not sure. Because I talked to Stephanie before, and I told Stephanie that I was doing whatever I could to help her out financially, because I reached out to my relatives, and the president instructed both the Philippine Olympic Committee and the Philippine Sports Commission to help her financially. And I know that this will also be done. And you know, I mean, look at Obiena, our pole vault champion.
EJ.
He won the bronze medal in the World Athletic Championships. He was willing to donate what was being given to him as a financial incentive. He's willing to donate that to Lidia De Vega. So, and I know that people, the former Gintong Alay athletes, the former group of Gintong Alay have also raised money. And I know that other people have also raised money, but I'm told that their bills are medyo mataas talaga. And so sana this can be addressed.
Okay. I know you have another meeting, Mayor Mike, pero habol ko lang ito. One final question. Ano po? You mentioned Gintong Alay, and you know, arguably, based on history, based on the achievements during the Gintong Alay program, which you headed, eh, parang it was the peak, you know, of the sports achievements of our Filipino athletes. I'm thinking now, by way of honoring Lidia's memory, no. And I don't know whether this is the proper time to ask it. Would you be open to the idea of being, at the very least, a consultant to the Philippine Sports Commission, Philippine Olympic Committee, the bodies, no, in sports?
Please understand, Peter, that members of the first family have reached out to me and have asked me to help study the possible appointments of new commissioners to the Philippine Sports Commission. Mm-hmm. Now, as you know, Bongku was already appointed as a commissioner. And remember, Bongku was a Gintong Alay athlete, okay? Right. And we actually have some names. I'm not at liberty to divulge those names now. But, you know, Peter, you have to understand, sports is in my blood. Okay, I'm always studying the condition of Philippine sport, and in whatever way I can, I will contribute. Kasi honestly, my personal opinion is that even though there's been individual victories, like Heidelin Diaz winning the Olympic gold, like the women's football team winning the ASEAN Cup, and other individual athletes performing well, overall, the sports system is still not as good as it should be. There's so much talent in this country. And I've said this time and time again. During Gintong Alay, we didn't look for Phil Am, Phil Britt, Phil this, Phil that. Okay? We always looked for indigenous talent. And there's so much talent in this country that sana the system can really be upgraded and made more sophisticated than it is now. Because believe me when I tell you this, Peter, the Philippines can be a sports power. Okay? It really can be a sports power. You know, we have good basketball players. We have good volleyball players. We have good bowlers. We have good shooters. We have good archers. We have a lot of talent in this country. It's just that a lot of the potential athletes fall through the cracks in the sistema. And the system is not geared properly. Kasi you have to really talent scout. You really have to be able to create full large training pools where you build up the athletes over a period of time. Athletes don't win gold medals overnight. Athletes are built up over a period of time, and they're subjected to systematic training under good coaches, receiving proper food supplements and having the proper equipment and having the proper exposure and having long-term training. And sana, we can really put together a better sports system in the country. And if I can contribute in any way, I will do so.
The problem with financial financial assistance, Mayor Keon, has been one of the major issues of our national athletes. Yun yung isa sa mga lagi natin naririnig. They require, they're asking for financial assistance. Are you also looking on this then, po?
Yes. Are you talking about financial assistance when they're competing or after they retire?
When they're competing. When they're competing.
Yeah, diba minsan, You know, please understand, when we had Gintong Alay, imagine during Gintong Alay, we only spent per year, of course, the peso was much stronger then. We spent mga just for track and field alone at that time, mga 5 to 8 million pesos only. And we were able to subject our athletes to first class training. They had first class equipment. They had first class exposure. You know, we have to learn to handle money properly. And there should be more money coming into sport. Because, you know, sport brings great honor and glory to the country. Athletes also that come especially from the marginalized sector use sports as a way to improve their lives economically. Okay? Mm-hmm. And this is why this should be seen as a way of really helping our people, helping the people of the Philippines, helping young men and women to tap their talent and rewarding them for the expressions of their sporting talent.
Yeah. Sabi nga nila, Mayor Keon, there's more politics in Philippine sports.
You know, Peter, there was politics in Philippine sports during my time, let alone now.
Yeah.
Peter, the Filipino is a political animal, okay? Yeah. So that's par for the course, okay? Yeah. But it's the way you navigate the politics. And that's why sana we can put people there who are intelligent enough to be able to navigate the politics within sport in such a way where we can really create a really good system and really cater to the welfare of the athletes and really have a good solid sports program, which will really bring out the talent in our young men and women.
I couldn't agree with you more. And let us start avoiding this sorry incidents like EJ Obiena and the Grandmaster Wesley Soa, no?
I'm really disappointed about the way EJ Obiena has been handled. That's really not good. And I really find that very surprising. Yeah. That imagine he's the only person to ever win a medal in the World Athletics Championship. And only recently he was considered to be a member in good standing of the Philippine Track and Field Association. I find that ironic.